What's happening everyone, my name is Alex and welcome back. In today's video we are checking out one of the most exciting products that I got to try this year. What I have here today, it's called the HoverAir X1 PROMAX. So this is basically the ultimate self-flying camera. Having one of these is basically like having a friend with you at all times that films you anytime you want. But this actually does a much better job than that friend, so you don't need that friend anymore anytime you wanna film some super cool videos. Just imagine for a second you have a flying GoPro, but with much, much better video quality, because the quality from GoPros is not that great. So the video quality that you're gonna get from this is mind-blowing. So this can record in 8K at 30 frames per second. Of course, it can also do 4K at 30, 60, and 120 frames per second. But I was mind blown by how good the video quality, mostly when you're recording in 8K at 30 frames per second, is from this drone. I think this is the best video quality I've seen from any drone up until now. So you can capture some incredible footage with this tiny little thing. This is also a folding drone, so you can fold it, it becomes this small, and it has a weight of just over 192 grams. So it's under that 250 gram limit for drones, so no regulations basically apply to this. But always check the regulations wherever you plan on flying the drone, because each country has different regulations, of course. Now, with this, you don't actually have to fly it yourself. This actually does all the flying by itself. You basically open it up, you power it on, then it takes off from your hand, then it comes back whenever it's done recording something. And it has a lot of flying modes. One of my favorite flying modes from this little self-flying camera has to be the orbit mode. So basically the camera will just fly around you, you're gonna be in the center, but this way you can actually show everything around you. What's really cool about each flying mode is the fact that you can actually customize everything about that particular flying mode. So you can have the drone flying a bit lower or a bit higher or further away from you. So it really depends where you're located, of course, because in some places you may not have that much space around you. And of course, you don't want the drone to be crashing into something. So you always have to kind of look around so you have an idea where the drone will go. But basically, you can capture some incredible footage if your imagination allows it, of course. Switching between those flying modes, it's also much easier than it was on the Hover X1. So I also have the first one that they released. But now we actually have a little screen right here on the drone, so you can actually see what flying mode you're in, and you can also see what settings you have for that particular flying mode. So we have a button here, well, we kind of have two buttons, three buttons really, because we have the center, we have left and right. So if you press either left or right, you can switch to different flying modes.
Zoom out.
And you can also hear the drone saying that. And once you press the button for the drone to fly out, it will basically say what mode you are in once again.
Follow. Cycling mode, indoor follow, 360 degrees spin.
So just so you get an idea of the flying modes that we have available. And as I said, you can customize all those flying modes based on your needs. You just have to install the Hover app on your phone. You connect to the drone and you can actually customize anything you want about each particular flying mode. From the app, of course, you can also download all the footage that you have saved on the little drone to your phone, and this also supports Wi-Fi 6, so the transfer speeds are actually quite fast compared to a lot of other drones available on the market. And that's important because you don't want to spend a lot of time downloading that footage to your phone. So very easy to move all the footage that you have on the drone to your phone so you can share it on social media and whatever. This can also fly with up to 60 kilometers an hour, and we even have a cycling mode available. So in the cycling mode, it will basically follow you, so you can get some super cool footage whenever you are riding your bike, because of course when you are riding the bike, you are going a bit faster than just walking. And these are some examples of recordings that I've done with this drone while I was on different bikes. because I actually use this this little camera a lot for my e-bike videos. So this is more than just like a leisure drone, basically. This is a tool for me because it does help me make those videos much cooler than if I wouldn't have something like this to film them. On one charge, this will also get up to 16 minutes of flying time. And you may think that 16 minutes is not enough, but let me tell you that in 16 minutes, you're gonna get a lot of footage. Not to mention that you can get different combos for it. So for example, I have the combo that has two battery packs. So I just charge both batteries before I go anywhere, and then I have over half an hour of flying time. And I'm not gonna be flying this that long, because any of those flying modes is basically not gonna take that long. I mean, you can take the drone when you go on a walk, for example, or a hike or something like that, so the drone can follow you for a longer period of time. And talking about that, this is some footage that I filmed the other day when we went on a hike. So you can see some super, super cool footage in some very unique locations. And you wouldn't be able to film anything like that unless you have something like this with you. I was also quite surprised to see how well this does, even if it's windy out, because in some locations where I took this to basically film myself, it was quite windy, and you can see that the footage from it is actually nice and steady. So of course it's using this little gimbal, so the camera is on a little gimbal, you can see it moving so it can keep the camera steady, and of course it's also using some type of video stabilization as well in those recordings, so you get some nice and steady footage. And a lot of the footage that you're gonna get from it, even in windy situations, looks quite good in my opinion. Another interesting upgrade compared to the original X1 here is the ability to take off from multiple locations. So now this can take off over water, from a cliff or anything like that. So you can basically fly this anywhere you are. So when I go to a super cool place, for example, if I do a zoom out, I basically keep this like this. So the cliff ends here, and this is basically flying over the cliff. And now you can do that as well, and then it will come back. And I think I actually had some footage of zoom out that I've done from a cliff, and that one also looks super cool. And again, everything that you've been seeing was recorded in 8K at 30 frames per second. You can also do those zoom out mods, for example, in other locations. So if you wanna show your car, for example, with a super cool view behind yourself, you can also do that. So you can basically fly this anywhere you want. Since we are talking about differences between the Pro Max and the original X1 here, so the Pro Max also adds a camera and some sensors on the back here. We also have another camera and some sensors at the bottom here. These are used as sensors for obstacle avoidance. So the bottom camera here is basically used whenever it lands on your hand. And the back here is used whenever you're using a mod like the Dolly Track. And since we're talking about that, Dolly Track basically allows you to walk or something like that, and the camera kind of flies in front of you. So you're walking towards the camera, and the camera basically flies back, if that makes sense. But I'm showing you some examples now so you understand what I'm saying. So it's like having someone in front of you that's filming you as you walk towards them. So a very, very different view, because typically you don't get anything like that. So if you wanna show where you are while you are walking, that Dolly Track mod is absolutely amazing. And now that we have that sensor on the back, the camera is not gonna crash into anything from behind itself. I'm hoping that in the future, with the next generation or something, maybe they will be able to add some sensors on the sides, so the camera basically doesn't crash into anything at any point, no matter what kind of flying you're doing. Now, because I have been using this, I have been using another one before this, I kind of know how to fly them, where to fly them, and I know how they're gonna react with stuff around themselves. So I don't fly them in situations where they're gonna crash. So you just have to look around and use your imagination so you can kind of know where this will be going, so it doesn't crash into something by mistake. Now, even if it crashes into something, it has all this protection around itself. So nothing will really happen to the camera. but you don't want it to crash because, well, it's an expensive product and you want to keep it for a long time. But if it does happen to crash, well, nothing will happen to it. This I actually haven't crashed yet, but this one I must have crashed like 20 times already. So that's also a great addition, having that sensor on the back there. Also, if you're looking for a more traditional way of flying this, there is also the beacon. We basically have a screen here and you can actually see everything the drone sees on that screen. You can also manually control that. And you can even connect this to the beacon. So this is kind of like the controller. You can have the phone sitting here as well, and you can basically fly this as a regular drone. So if you want more manual control over it, you can definitely buy something like this and control it manually. But personally, I find myself just using it without a controller because it does fly so nice by itself. And you don't actually need to carry anything extra with you. So it is entirely up to you, but if you want more manual control, you can get that with this. But if you don't want to carry any extra weight, you just take the drone with you and you can film whatever you want, wherever you want, and the drone does all the flying by itself. So to quickly conclude this video, having the ability to have a camera that flies by itself and also recording in 8K 30 frames per second, that gives you a lot of flexibility of what you can actually do with that footage. Not to mention the footage does look super crisp and super sharp. Pretty much everything that I got from it, all the recordings look absolutely stunning. So having that massive video file, you can actually crop it however you want. So if you wanna film something in a super cool location and crop it for Instagram, for example, you definitely can because that file is so massive that it's not gonna lose any quality whenever you're cropping it. I'm gonna put on the screen now three crops that I have done from some recordings. I'll have them side by side because I can basically fit them all on one screen. But you have the ability to crop that 8K footage however you want. And of course, if you wanna do something in slow motion or anything like that, that's not really my style, but you could record in 4K at 120 frames per second. And the crazy part is that this does all the flying by itself. You don't actually have to do anything. You basically put your hand out, it takes off from your palm, then it comes back whenever it's done, it lands, and that's pretty much all you have to do. So an amazing tool, mostly if you're in this line of work where I am, where I film a lot of products outdoors. So this makes the videos that I film, the recordings, look much, much cooler. And basically, if you take this with you traveling anywhere, it's gonna change all those videos and everything that you're basically gonna be posting on social media. The possibilities are pretty much unlimited. Well, as always, there will be some links in the video description if you wanna check this out. If you do have any questions, feel free to leave some comments down below and I'll try to answer whatever questions you may have. Thanks for watching and I'll see you guys in the next one.